Boys! Big boys!
I believe we should encourage personal responsibility so people can be held accountable for their actions. I believe in a government which is responsible to the school. There's a big difference between my opponents' philosophies and mine. They trust government, and I trust no one but myself to be president. I trust you to invest some of your own lunch money for higher returns. I trust local people to submit to their own schools. I do not trust you with a budget surplus. We should help people live their lives and also run their lives. I'm asking for your vote. Okay, so I understand how the ad could have been taken as a little pushy, maybe intense, but in my defense, I'm telling the truth. Oh, the investment line? Yeah, I find it crazy how no one in this school invests their lunch money in stocks. Like, I made a killing investing in Apple. I could buy you, you know?
He could. He's not...
Do not interrupt me, Stan.
But I...
What did I literally just say? Do not interrupt me. I'm sorry about that. Can you just not release this footage?
Can you make my title Martin's best friend? You know, Martin is like my best friend in the whole world. And a lot of people tell me, like, I should find a new best friend because he's abusive or whatever. Like, I don't know, like, this morning he told me that if I put cream in his coffee one more time, he'd skin me and turn me into a lamb. Like, that's just his sense of humor. I mean, you gotta crack a few eggs to make an omelet. I mean, I don't really know what that means, but Martin says it a lot, so I think I get it.
A lot of people in Croton are doing things with their lives. A lot of people are getting ready for things. I'm also getting ready for something.
I'm running for president.
Well, I've actually been running for president for a while now. I've run every year I could. I haven't won yet, though.
I mean, I don't know. Ned's, like, fine. He was in my art class freshman year, and he was kind of just, like, a weird kid. I know I lent him a pencil once, and, like, normally that wouldn't bother me, but, like, the way he took it, I don't know. He's kind of just, like, a weird kid. I don't like being around him, but he's nice. He probably won't get my vote.
You know, maybe I'm not the most popular kid. Maybe I'm not the bee's knees. Maybe I'm not the best dressed or have the most pencils, but I really think that I can make a difference in this community. By spreading acceptance and friendliness, I strongly believe...
Yo, what up? Try to ignore the football highlights, but you know, I'm kind of nice with it, so like, understand them if you can't. So you already know who it is. It's your boy, Chad Brosnick. We out here running for Prez. I know my injury got me bad, but we back. We out here. Let's get it, boys. And girls, you know, we don't precipitate. Just hit me up with any questions. Chad and I approve this message.
So why did I think the football highlights were a good idea? Well, you know, it's sort of like this alpha wolf kind of thing. By showing my physical prowess, I kind of subtly show to my viewers that I am the alpha and they are the delta. I also had everything like lined up on my mom's computer already. So, yeah. What am I busy with? You know, nothing much, just the prank of the century. I'm still in the planning phase, but all I know is this presidency is pretty much mine.
Shay! Shay, Shay!
Oh. I don't want to be in your stupid documentary. I don't. Are you rolling right now?
Pencil?
Yeah.
Thank you. Yeah.
Can I just give you that?
No, I was just using it.
That was kind of rude.
Okay, so it's actually kind of funny, but in elementary school, there was this incident. So yeah, I was in class one day and I had these pencils. They were like really, really sharp pencils, because, I mean, I like pencils. I bought them with 3 weeks worth of allowance, and they smelled really nice. They were the smental kind. So to get a better whiff, I put them straight up my nose, and the whole class kind of saw, and so did the teacher. And from there, the rest is history, man. Everyone makes fun of me for it.
How do you feel about that?
I mean, it was a long time ago. I don't know why everyone keeps talking about it. Like, it's just pencils, and it was one time. And some people can't seem to let go of it. Even in the sophomore year of high school, it's been 7 years, 124 days since then. You know, it's actually kind of funny looking back on it. Someone told me that I could get some community service hours by cleaning up the halls and helping out the janitors. So I've been scrubbing toilets and it's not even that bad. I really think it's helping my campaign.
Yo, Ned.
Hey, Chad.
Ned, what's up? Can I see that room for a second?
Of course you can.
Oh, thanks, man. Thanks. Oh, one more thing. Here you go, buddy.
What is this?
Don't worry about it.
Chad, you're cleaning up. You know, just trying to learn from my mistakes. Be a help.
Great to see you take initiative. Another broken pencil?
No, it was Chad's.
Another broken pencil. Come on.
Hey Martin, so I was thinking for like a fundraiser idea, we could do a movie in the auditorium, you know? It would be a lot of fun.
Stan, that is the worst idea that you've had yet.
Okay. Well, maybe we could pass out flyers.
Can you just be quiet? I'm trying to think.
Okay, God.
You know what I was thinking? We could hand out flyers.
That's a great idea. Yeah.
And that's why I said it.
Oh, B.
Now, I was thinking the idea was more of an A+. You know, I'm excited.
Martin, help.
Stan, would you be quiet? I'm trying to think. God, Nave.
No, Martin, a B.
I may have a fear of bees.
Where is it? Where'd it go?
Stan. I got it.
Okay, Martin was trying to swat the bee, and I couldn't move out of the way. After he hit me, like, he picked me up, he got me my hot chocolate, and we went to the nurse's office to get a tissue, and now we're here. He's so nice, and he really does care about me. My nose is just fragile, you know? It's a genetic thing. I need that surgery or whatever, you know? It's genetic. It's 100% genetic. I'm weak.
I'm alive.
I'm alive!
The bee is without a doubt the most fearsome creature in the animal kingdom. In life and in eventual death, I wish to mimic the bee. My opponents will fear me. I will sting them. To prevail, one must become what they fear. I will become the bee. With that, I will attack you, losing half my body in the process if you get in between me and my ambitions. I may bleed out and die a slow and horrible death, but the damage has been done. Speaking of stings, I actually hit Stan in the face. Jeez. If I want to be honest, I'd do it again. I fear I've acquired a taste for violence. I can still feel his face on my fist. Yeah, I'm fine.
So, Martin's afraid of bees. Good to know. Good to know.
Take care of somebody.
All right, who's this guy? Who do you need taken care of?
Okay, Ned.
Really? All right, he was already on my list, so that's fine by me. At least I get paid for it. Get out of here. Go.
Thomas, here you go, buddy.
Oh, thanks, man.
Never come in this hallway again.
I've had worse Wednesdays.
Yeah, Chad, I don't know him that well, but I had A2 trig with him last year, and every single day when we had a test, he would try and cheat off me. And the teacher would catch him literally every single time, but he tried again and again and again. He's the stupidest person I've ever met.
Chad,
I'm doing something.
We need to talk about your GPA. It's dangerously low.
Look, I'm focusing on this prank right now.
Chad, you're going to repeat senior year if you don't pick up your grades. What are you doing?
I'm trying to finish this prank. And look, to me, this is art right here. This is art.
Are you seriously going to let a prank interfere with your GPA?
I mean,
is that where we are now?
Yeah, I mean, all I'm saying is that I think this is a masterpiece of artwork, and I should be getting a scholarship for what I'm doing right here.
You're not going to get into Harvard with a 0.3 GPA, Chad. Let's face it. You're not even going to get out of the fourth grade.
I hear a B.
You need more than a B. You need an A. You need to focus your attention on your grades. On your grades! You have valedictorian potential, I have no doubt about it.
I don't need no validation. I just need to focus on this prank.
Today is the speeches and voting, so I'm pretty excited. I mean, I'm not exactly expecting to win, but I just want to put myself.
I have a positive outlook on this. I believe the wisdom of the people will prevail, and I will come out on top.
Yeah, I mean, hopefully.
Yo, today's the day! Trap is all set. Now I just get to sit back and watch it all unfold. I am become death, destroyer of worlds.
Is that an Oppenheimer quote?
Who? Dude, these quotes are all natural. Straight from the garden of my mind.
really net more pencils.
It's so dark in here.
Ah! Hey! Ah! Oh my God! Ah!
Stan Martin, main office, right now.
Hello, everyone. Today we are electing class presidents. I, as you know, I'm already your president. I was president for last year. Today we have three speeches. Can we have Martin come up? Martin? Martin? Okay. Next we have Ned.
No!
Ned?
Wait, I'm here. I'm here.
Chad says good luck.
All right. I really want this position. I've been running for this position my whole life and for as long as I've been at this school. You know? I really think I can make some changes at this school that would positively. You know what? To everyone here, all I've ever been is nice and understanding. And you just treat me with this much disrespect. I do your homework, and you just frame me and throw pencils at me. Like, you know what? I'm out of the running. I can't do this anymore. I'm not doing anybody else's homework. Yeah, that's you, James. I just can't do this. This is so stupid.
Thank you, Ned. Finally, we have Chad. Chad, is Chad here? Nobody wants to show up?
Whoa!
Show up. Okay. I guess the only one to win is... Wait. Don't we have... I think we have one more. Shay? Shay Stevenson?
It's me.
Shay?
It's me. Do I have to make a speech anymore, mister?
No? All right. I win. Thank you. Thank you all. No, thank you. I don't like you guys.
So, did the election already happen?
Yeah.
So, who won?
Shay.
Who?
Yeah, apparently there was someone else running. He just kept a low profile and we forgot about him.
It's kind of my fault, because I had the whole prank planned out so close to perfection. I just left him out. I don't know how that happens. Like, I don't know how I forgot about that. It's kind of like a Shakespearean tragedy, you know, if you think about it.
Since when do you know anything about literature?
What?
So, where's your henchman guy?
Who? Stan? Yeah, who cares?
Dude, what did you do to deserve Stan? All he does is help you, and all you do is shut him down. He's gonna leave you one day.
What? That... that is not true. Stan doesn't have the guts to leave me. No, what do you know? Shut up, Ned.
Dude, you shut up. No one likes you. They only tolerate you because you give them money. Everybody except Stan.
He's kind of right, you know? I mean, if you think about it, no one really likes... any of us, after all this?
I'm not gonna listen to this. Listen, I'm gonna go. Those thugs could be after me any minute.
Just say you're going to find Stan, dude.
Where have you been, man?
I went to go pay those gang guys back. Huh. They seem pretty mad that we didn't pay earlier, but I went to the teacher's line and got some coffee. I spilled some of yours, though.
I'm not gonna skin you, Stan. You did the best that you could. I presume. You'll do better next time, though, alright? Hey, how did you pay those guys back?
I used some of my allowance money. It was a little over 100, but didn't seem to mind.
You used your own money?
So, yeah. What else was I gonna do? Steal it?
Take it. Come on, take it. The more you wait, the more you use up my good graces. Come on.
Thanks, man. Never really.
Hey, man, you know, I'm really sorry about all this. If everything had gone to plan, I would have won.
Is that supposed to make me feel better?
I don't know, dude. Like, I've just been, like, reflecting on this whole situation. And, like, I kind of forget why I hate you.
I feel like you forget a lot of things, Jed.
You're right, bro. I'm like, there was this one time where I had a test and I was so confident, I studied the entire night. It was the first time I've ever studied in my life, and I've been in high school for 6 years. And it turns out when I got to the test, I saw fractions on the page. Well, at least it said fractions. I don't actually know what a fraction is. It's like something over something. I don't know. But I spent the entire night studying great English literature and the Cold War, which is like totally my bad. And like that's completely my mix-up. But yeah, I guess you're right. I do forget a lot of things.
How the actual f*** do you mess up math with English literature and the Cold War?
I think I was trying to, like, type in cool math games, but I typed in Cold War games. I really don't know how I messed it up. But by the way, what an awful casting of Matthew Broderick in that movie. I mean, not the best choice.
I legitimately have no idea what you're talking about. But hey, if you have any tests coming up, I can help you with those. And I also kind of need a ride home.
You do that for me?
Sure, I just need a ride home, honestly.
I like that. You help me. I help you. Yeah, I can do that.
Hey, where have you two been?
Just here. You know, we're actually about to leave. I was gonna give him a ride and we were gonna go study at his house.
Could we actually catch a ride? The mercenaries I hired slashed my tires.
Yeah, why not?
I know I'm almost looking like a fool right now, but we should actually get going.
Yeah, sure. So, like, over this past school year of, you know, running for class president and everything, and, like, trying to use a prank to, like, win, it was a great idea. I mean, like, it just didn't work out perfectly. I wasn't planning on falling down the stairs. Should have thought that out. All I've realized is just that life is kind of one big political.
Boys!